What's going on, YouTube? This is SG1 Sports here at the Voice of College Football. If you're a Big Ten fan, please subscribe to our Big Ten channel. If you're an Iowa fan, please subscribe to our Iowa channel. In this video, we are going to break down the 2022 schedule for the Hawkeyes. Before we get into 2022, let's look back at the 2021 schedule. Here is the schedule from 2021. Iowa, it worked out pretty well for them. And a schedule that we thought was going to be really tough turned out to not be quite as tough as we thought. For one thing, Iowa State did not, they weren't as good as everyone thought they were going to be. You know, preseason, Iowa State was a top 10 team. They wound up not even finishing in the top 25. You had Indiana there to kick off the season, thought that that was going to be a huge game. Indiana, maybe a dark horse in the Big Ten East. They wound up finishing dead last in the Big Ten East. They also played Maryland out of the East, who wasn't that great. And they got Penn State at home out of the East. So a really nice schedule last season. Maybe part of the reason why Iowa was able to win their division and go to the Big Ten Championship. So that schedule set up pretty well for them. I don't know if they're going to be as fortunate in 2021. Or 2022, I should say. Let's look at that schedule now. And before we go game by game, let's look at who they play outside of the Big Ten West, because obviously they're going to play every team in the Big Ten West, but this is the schedule outside of their division. They'll play South Dakota State, Iowa State, and Nevada. So very winnable games here. They could easily go 3-0 in non-conference play once again. Nevada is not a team you want to sleep on. A pretty good team out of the Mountain West. Iowa State, the rivalry, we know about that. But if Iowa State couldn't beat them last year, you know, it's hard to imagine Iowa State winning this year on the road. And South Dakota State's a pretty good FCS team, so it's not a cakewalk non-conference schedule, but Iowa should have a good shot at winning all three of those games. But look at who they play out of the East. They're going to play Rutgers on the road, so that's good. You get Rutgers, but then they're going to play Michigan and Ohio State, so the top two teams more than likely out of the East, Michigan and Ohio State, and they have to play Ohio State on the road. So that is a very tough schedule there, at least in the Big Ten. So non-conference, not too bad. Their cross-division matchups, pretty tough. So let's look at the whole schedule now. They start with South Dakota State on September 3rd. Then they'll play Iowa State after that on the 10th and Nevada on the 17th. All three of those non-conference games will be at home. They'll get them all out of the way to start off the season, and then they will begin Big Ten play with Rutgers on September 24th. That game will be on the road, but still a great shot for Iowa to start off the season 4-0. Then they'll get Michigan at home on October the 1st. That's going to be a huge game, especially if Iowa is 4-0 at that point. Possibly a top 10, top 15 matchup there. A really big game. And if Iowa is going to have a chance to get to that next level, maybe be a playoff contender, they're going to have to win this game. It's at home. It's a great opportunity. You really need to win this game, but it's going to be tough. We know Michigan has a lot coming back, especially on the offensive side of the ball. So that'll be a tough matchup there. They play Illinois after that. So if they can get through Michigan, if they can win that game, pretty good chance that Iowa starts the season off 6-0. Not a guarantee. Obviously, Rutgers, Illinois on the road, you never know. But if they can beat Michigan, they could start off 6-0 before playing Ohio State on the 22nd. They'll have a bye week before playing Ohio State. This is still going to be a really tough matchup, though, on the road at Ohio State. You don't really like Iowa's chances in this game, but you never know. We'll see what happens and see what the teams look like once we roll around to the start of the season, or actually get into the season. But that'll be a very tough game. But after that, some, you know, a manageable schedule. They have Northwestern on the 29th. Then they'll play Purdue on November 5th. That'll be a tough game on the road. Purdue should be pretty solid this year. They play Wisconsin on November 12th. Always a huge game in the Big Ten, in the Big Ten West. And so they'll play Purdue and Wisconsin back-to-back. I believe what we just saw is they played them back-to-back this past year, the teams that beat them. And then they'll have Minnesota on the 19th. They'll play them on the road. That could be a tough matchup. And then Nebraska on the Friday after Thanksgiving, November 25th. Also going to be a tough one there. Nebraska figures to be a quality team this year, and they lost so many close games last year. I don't expect them to be a pushover by any means, but you know, it's a tough schedule. It's a grind week in and week out. You've got games that are going to be tough, really starting really all of Big Ten play. I mean, even Rutgers and Illinois on the road won't be easy wins, but you got Michigan, Ohio State, Northwestern at home. that one maybe should, maybe Iowa will take care of business and win that one easily. But then you got Purdue on the road, Wisconsin, at Minnesota, Nebraska. Four really tough division games to close out the season. And those games are going to determine whether or not Iowa wins this division. I mean, those will be the four games that determine, you know, where Iowa stands in this division. Even if they lose to Michigan and Ohio State, if they can win the rest of these games and finish with two losses and go undefeated in the division, they're going to have a great chance to go to the Big Ten Championship, winning the Big Ten West, a really good shot. But for me, if I'm looking at this schedule and I'm thinking bigger picture, if I'm thinking about the college football playoff for Iowa, they're going to have to win a lot of close games. Don't have to beat Ohio State on the road. Obviously, that's going to be a tough one, but you get Michigan at home, and if you can win these games in your division, then you never know. Maybe Iowa could sneak into that conversation, but this schedule definitely going to be tough in 2022.